Hello, everybody. Welcome back to my channel, where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I couldn't be bothered to get ready this morning. Do you think less of me? I'm going to do my skincare. But today I thought we could take a look at some of the worst that beauty TikTok has to offer. It's the morning. I'm not particularly greasy or anything, so I'm just going to go over with a micellar water. These pumpy bottles are from Amazon, by the way, and in expensive pharmacies in London. These are some of the more questionable or just generally interesting beauty-related videos that you have tagged me in or that have come across on TikTok. So let's have a look.
Hi, friends. My name's Becca. I used to be a makeup content creator on TikTok. Wasn't very big, whatever. But I'm here with a PSA. This up here is pink eye and cellulitis, plus some burst blood vessels from pressure in my head, all because I used expired makeup from my very old makeup collection that I shouldn't have. So the whole point of this video is I'm going to show you the makeup I used that I shouldn't have, plus the makeup I now have to throw. Kat Von D, when it was still Kat Von D, Satin Sinner Palette. This is the culprit, and specifically, Relic. This is, my absolute favorite gold eyeshadow on the face of the planet. Not anymore, baby. Not anymore. So, you see what I mean when I say, going to be for display only, never to be put on an eye. Well, definitely not an eyeball on an eyelid, but you know what I mean.
So this creator goes on to share that she basically also used an eyeliner, some false lashes as well. And here's the thing, I feel like I'm obviously not on the makeup side of TikTok, but I do see a lot of people being like using makeup from my old school bag that's like 10 years old. And I do feel that to a certain degree, you can use certain beauty products like a little bit past their use by date. But I do think you have to be careful when it comes to things like your eyes. So I did a little research into what kind of bacteria can grow on expired eyeshadow. And I found that's just typically common environmental bacteria such as Staphylococcus, Pseudomonas, and Bacillus species. And these are common when eyeshadow palettes, for example, has been exposed to air and skin contact and kind of going back and forth. So obviously when you're putting that around your eye, you're gonna be at risk of bacterial contamination. Things that come in tubes like foundation and stuff can just irritate the skin. Things like mascara can get contaminated too because you're essentially sometimes you can pull off eyelashes and you're dipping that back in, the same kind of bacteria can grow. So it's interesting, risky. It made for a good video to watch. I felt so bad for her. Because like I said, you see these people using expired makeup on TikTok all the time. Not that that's like a good thing, but it seems to have been like a bit of a trend and people seem to be getting away with it. They seem to be unscathed. I'm gonna use the Tear Tear Milky Toner. Despite what it looks like, I've been using this for some time. It just never seems to go down. It's a very nice, more on the moisturizing side of milky toners, but still nice and light. Smells a little bit like plastic. Here's another video about a very old skincare trend that's kind of making its way around the internet again.
If you grab a clove of garlic and you peel it right, and then you take it in your mouth and swallow it like this. You will have just taken something that is going to help with inflammation on your skin, in your gut. It's going to be antibacterial. It's going to help fight acne. It is literally the easiest, naturalest hack you could do for the skin. Also, don't chew the garlic and try not to break it down as much because then you will really stink of garlic.
Did she say clove? Did she say clove of garlic? I think she did. Listen, I love garlic. I love it and everything. Unfortunately, I have IBS, so I do have to be very careful. This isn't gonna do shit. This isn't gonna do anything. Here's the thing. If a clove of garlic worked to help heal acne, people would be doing this non-stop and we would have found the cure to acne. This is kind of what annoys me about these all natural trends, is that sometimes they're just rooted in nothingness. Absolutely nothing. Or they take one fact about garlic and maybe how it interacts with our body or the kind of ingredients within a clove of garlic, then do hop, skips and jumps to what it may also do for your skin. Very rarely is food or drink that you ingest gonna directly help with the skin. It's also really dangerous to just swallow a whole clove of garlic. There are kids on this app who can't even like play with Lego without putting it in their mouth. I'm gonna use Bloom Effects Tulip Dew Drops. I've been using this brand loads and I've, oh shit, that's how you do it. And I barely talk about them, but some of that, you you'll probably see it in like a couple months time or in a month's time, but I love this just throughout the day, really kind of help give my skin a glow, but also keep it like well hydrated and moisturized and calmed, especially as the weather here was getting warmer, but now it's just like raining and it's that horrible sideways rain that really irritates my skin. I don't mean to be mean, but sometimes I look at these things and I'm like, where's the common sense in this? Like, just think about if all these hacks really did work, these skin issues wouldn't be an issue. They would have created these garlic pills that you can take that magically cures your acne. You know, take one a day with water and it's magically gonna cure your acne. People have been rubbing it on their faces. It just doesn't work. There's not really a science behind it either. Like I said, somebody has probably taken something that's good about garlic and then gone through many like whispering challenge kind of thing to get to what they say garlic does for your skin. Something's been misinterpreted along the way. It's bizarre to see people in this day and age, go back to these early 2000s Pinterest skincare DIY natural home remedy hacks when the skincare world especially has come on leaps and bounds since then. There are so many things available in your drugstore, Target, whatever, that can help with your skin that weren't available back when natural DIY kind of took over. So it's kind of like a bit depressing seeing these people actually do this. This is one that I kind of get why people believe this, but I also think it's a bit of like a placebo effect.
Besties, these are my latest obsession. It's time for me to take it off, so it like suctions the wrinkles out of your head. I still have these like light wrinkles, but they're getting so much lighter, and this is me trying to move my forehead. And I usually can do like a big move, but mm-mm. Yes, obsessed. It's like natural Botox and really, really cheap too. And reusable, are you kidding me? Excellent deal right now.
A really, genuinely really good product. I love these kind of silicone reusable patches for a number of things. You know how I feel when people say it's like Botox. Just get Botox, because nothing is like Botox. These reusable silicone patches are actually really good for two things. First thing they do is they work as kind of like this occlusive layer. So like suctioning out of wrinkles, she said, that lessening of fine lines is purely because your skin's being plumped up. You could do this with slugging. If you put a pimple patch, like one of those long patches over wrinkles, you're gonna see the same effect over a couple of nights until you stop doing it. You know, it's not gonna get rid of them. The more you occlude and hydrate your skin, it can potentially help plump out those fine lines. Another way these work is by simply restricting your facial movements. Now, from what I understand, you don't really make too many facial movements at night. I know some people get more restless sleep and they probably do. But during the day when we're talking and expressing ourselves, that's probably when you should be using these products, these silicone patch thingies, because the idea is to train yourself to stop making those movements. These work by restricting you, like physically stopping you from doing those movements. So, with that being said, I can see why people think they kind of disable your muscles like Botox does, but that's not what they do. You'll still be able to move when you take them off. It's not going to stop your face from moving, but the idea is that it's going to kind of train you to stop making those bigger movements. So instead of when I laugh, I like do this. If I was wearing a silicone patch, it wouldn't allow me to do that. So when I have that off, the idea is that when I laugh, instead of being like this, I'll be like, physically pulling less expressions. But these don't stop your muscles moving. Like she would have been able to physically do that. The idea is that you kind of just feel like a phantom silicone pad on your face, so you stop doing it. Does that make sense? I think I explained that really bad, but that's not to say these aren't good products. They can genuinely help. I'm actually going to be making a video on this, but of course the less movement you make in your face, the less fine lines and movement wrinkles and stuff like that you're going to have. But a quicker way to do it and a more effective way to do it is to get Botox. But these are actually a really good affordable option if you can sleep in them every night. My only issue is these don't stick if you use thick serums or even like really watery hydration-y kind of ingredients and moisturizer. They just slip off. I tried to sleep with this exact brand. I think it's Pacifica. I tried to sleep with these on. They just slide off the face. So I gave up and got Botox. The next video is one of those things that you forget unless you're really into skincare that people don't really know.
Can someone duet this video and show me the actual UV coverage for this like super goop SPF powder, because I have no idea if it's actually doing anything or if I'm just rubbing this on my face aimlessly. Or it'd be even cooler if super goop can do the UV LED light test, because I'm keen to know. Thank you.
This very much reminds me of the SPF in your makeup kind of idea. I'm just gonna moisturize now. I'm gonna use the Astura Atto Barrier. The idea that yes, this will have the right sunscreen protection enough if you use the right amount, a significant amount in this case. So you would have to cake your face in these powders. It was Lab Muffin, obviously, of course, always, Michelle from Lab Muffin, who actually did an example on a YouTube short to show you how that powder would sit on your face if you were using enough, and it's not nice. It doesn't look good. The makeup will look very cakey. Is cakey the right word for powder? It will look very thick and powdery. It's just not enough coverage. I think it's nice to use if you want to maybe reapply your sunscreen, then go over the top with this sunscreen powder, but you just aren't getting the right coverage. I honestly feel like they're kind of useless in general as a sunscreen product, but I'm not against having some kind of sun protection in every single product. It can only do good, right? Well, sometimes there's no point at all in this case. You know what I mean? Though, like, you shouldn't rely on this as your main sunscreen or even as a reapplication sunscreen unless you want to look like a powdery mess, you know? It's just never gonna be good enough coverage. Oh, okay. Oh my god. I actually can't believe this next product exists. That is supposedly a Lush reusable sheet mask. Well, reusable up to 7 days, but from the looks of it, it looks like after one use, it falls apart. This one is called Bunny, but it looks like somebody has taken the skin off somebody else, a human, and put it on theirs. It's absolutely terrifying. So Lush say, get bright-eyed and bushy-tailed with this brightening blend of pineapple and pomegranate juices that illuminates your skin. Meanwhile, kaolin clay offers a deep cleanse and glycerin keeps you soft and hydrated. They say you need to apply this to damp skin and leave for 10 minutes. Once opened, this mask will be reused for 7 days. Just wrap it back up and put it in the fridge between uses. It just kind of looks revolting, like absolute revolting. They have one called Prince Charming as well, which is like a frog, but it looks absolutely disgusting. I know Lush are very much about zero waste and not affecting the environment as much as they can, but for me, this isn't gonna do anything. Like, I bet by the third use, there's no juices left on it to use, there's nothing really penetrating your skin, it's all kind of in this like gelatin-y kind of form that honestly I don't think is gonna have much effect on your skin. Lush are also known for adding a lot of essential oils and very irritating fragrance to their products, and you know I'm all for fragrance. I love it in my skincare. I just think Lush use a lot to make up for a lot of other things, and it's almost too much. As I mentioned, I know they're all about zero waste as much as they can be, which, you know, you have to applaud them for that. They actually do a good job at it. This is where a reusable silicone sheet mask will come in much better. You have it for your life. In general, it's a lot less waste. One from Experiment, they're my favorite because they're actually 3D. They come in two different sizes. People are like, oh, you get them cheap off Temu. They're not the same. The Experiment ones are so comfortable. You can use it with whatever serum you like or moisturizer, depending on what your skin needs that day. These are just A, terrifying, and B, I think a little bit wasteful. I'm gonna be honest. I know that's not what they're for, but I just don't think that this was a good idea in any way. I think they're all, are they discontinued? Were they limited edition? Oh no, they're in stock. I'm gonna buy it. Oh my God. Okay, let's talk about this video because I have a few things to say about this one. We all know that flaxseed mask, but I also think someone's lying.
You see this? I don't have any foundation on, but this is my skin. Like, without foundation, like, but when I tell you this mask is amazing, it is, and you guys have to try it at home. This is a flaxseed mask. It literally is two ingredients, and it does so much for your skin. It lightens your dark spots, fixes hyperpigmentation, tightens your skin, moisturizes your skin, and it's even like Botox. Like, jump scare, but this is what it looks like on, and you keep it on so your face is super tight. I saw this one girl talk about it on here, and I was like, oh my God, I wanna talk about it too, because I've been using it forever. But when I tell you I've seen such a big difference in my skin when I started using this, I mean it. Because it not only lightens my dark spots, along with other products, obviously, but it tightens my face and it just feels like Botox in a bottle, except at home. Like, screw that $100 Botox, because this is amazing. Like, I considered getting Botox, but then I tried using this mask and honestly, don't even think about it anymore. I still want that nose job though.
What? First of all, her skin looks incredible. It does. Her before and afters, incredible. What nose job does she want? Her nose is so cute. It's really, really nice. Flaxseed can't do half the shit that she said it can do. All this flaxseed mask can do is temporarily hydrate. It could give you a nice cooling feeling, so it could kind of soothe your skin. It's not gonna work like Botox in any way. It's not gonna reduce dark spots in any way. It can't do that. Scientifically, there is no reason it would do that. What I also found interesting about her video was she used this before and after. That, to me, is not relevant to this mask. And I only say that because I'm not accusing anyone of lying, but when you look through her other videos, you can see that she contributes a lot of other products to helping with her acne. So I don't actually think the timeline doesn't add up to when she said she had acne versus when she started using this mask. We can see in one video she's using a lot of Korean beauty. This is all Beauty of Joseon, so I wonder if that's sponsored. Great brand, but she talks about using those products before. And she also talks about using Panoxyl as well, which we know is a great face wash for people with acne. So I don't think this, I'm not accusing anyone of lying, but I think the placebo effect is in full swing. I even think people are forgetting what's real. I don't know the exact timeline of her videos, but I did take a good look at her profile and her content's really interesting, but her acne timeline doesn't add up with when this mask went viral or when she posted about this video. This mask may give you very temporary tightening effect, as soothing and cooling things do. In my opinion, it's messy and it's a waste of time. I'm gonna use this product from this Chinese brand. I don't actually know what the brand is called. Oh, Alternative Stereo. This is their lip potion steaming milk. I actually got this before Good Light came out with their kind of like lip toner, and it kind of helps my lips feel hydrated before I put on any kind of lip balm. So I'm just going to finish off with a hand cream. This is Prequel's Hand Wrap. I love this because it's nice and moisturizing without feeling like a shitty like Nivea hand cream that just like takes forever to rub in and leaves you feeling greasy and oily. So there we have it. Let me know if you can relate to any of these, if you've used any of these products or DIYs. Also, keep tagging me in videos on TikTok over, what is it? James_S_Welsh. You've got some more TikTok related videos here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.